Welcome back friends once again in this video tutorial of Anita Bio Concept, and today I am going to discuss only the outline of culture, culturing the protoplast. In very short I am just telling the process of culturing of protoplast, because in my next upcoming videos I will be discussing in detail. So I am just giving the outline of how protoplast can be cultured. Protoplast culture just after the isolation of protoplast. Okay, so protoplast may be cultured in a suitable media. Okay, and there are various ways. So we require suitable culture media to culture the protoplast. This is the requirement, and there are different ways known as which I'll be discussing in detail later on. Bergman's plating technique. This is one of the very important technique, Bergman plating technique of culturing protoplast, which is being performed in agar media. Okay, and second one is using a thin layer of liquid medium, we can culture the protoplast. And another process is by micro drop method, by following the micro drop method. So there are three process by the help of which we can culture the protoplast. So I'll discuss in detail later on. Okay, within 2 to 4 days protoplast readily regenerated. After following these methods, it takes 2 to 4 days for the protoplast to be regenerated, and after 2 to 4 days protoplast are being readily regenerated. They are readily regenerated cell wall. They regenerate the cell wall, and then they undergo mitosis in order to form the macroscopic colonies. Okay, then they undergo mitosis to form the microscopic colonies, and these microscopic colonies can be induced. These macroscopic colonies can be induced to regenerate. They can be induced to regenerate the whole plant. Okay, so culture media are being used for the culturing of protoplast, and nowadays generally B5 media and MS media along with their modifications are being used for the culturing of protoplast, or for the process of protoplast culture, and the media are generally supplemented with suitable osmoticum and phytohormones such as auxin and cytokinin. And in what concentration, in what percentage, or in what concentrations auxins or cytokinins will be used, that totally depends upon the types of cells we are using. So this is the general process of culturing or culture of protoplast. Okay, so you must be thinking about the concentration of auxin and cytokinin. So it totally depends upon the type of cells we are using for the protoplast culture. After 7 to 10 days of culture, cell wall is regenerated. Okay, cell wall is regenerated after culturing of protoplast, and osmolarity of the medium is gradually reduced to that of normal medium. Okay, osmolarity also is being gradually reduced to that of normal medium, and after that macroscopic colonies are transferred transferred onto normal tissue culture media. Okay, macroscopic colonies of the protoplast developed are being transferred onto the normal tissue culture media, and protoplasts are cultured in diffuse light. Okay, protoplasts are generally cultured in diffuse light or dark because protoplasts are very sensitive. They are very sensitive to light. So this is the very basic outline of how protoplast can be cultured, and about this culturing of protoplast protocol or process I'll be discussing in detail in my next upcoming video. So till then, thank you all.